Well, utility bills are expected to rise as the weather gets colder, but you know, there's some things you can do to save money. One of them, they say, is upgrading your thermostat.
Yes, Consumer Reports found some of the best programmable thermostats on the market in their latest issue. And joining us now to tell us more, Consumer Reports Senior Home Editor Dan DeClerico. Hey, Dan, good to see you.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Well, so how many of these programmable thermostat controllers did you test, and what were you looking for?
Yeah, so we tested about 30 devices. We're really looking for ease of use. These programmable thermostats used to be really hard to program, so hard, in fact, that people ended up using more energy, not less. So we were really looking for ease of setup, ease of programming.
And can you replace what you currently have? I mean, do you have to already have a digital or one in place, or can you swap out from those kind of rotary dial ones?
Yeah, old-fashioned dial. Yeah, no, it's very easy to retrofit. It's just switching a couple wires.
So. Okay, so talk about this. Why is this one best?
So, yeah, this is our Honeywell $300. This is our top-scoring overall thermostat. Unfortunately, you can't see it, but it has a very sharp, crystal-clear display. The touchpad controls are very intuitive. All the prompts are there, and it was very easy to connect to our wireless router, which is really important.
Okay, so that means I can control it with my computer.
That's correct. Yeah, that's an important point. This whole product category has gotten really interesting. A few years ago, there were only a handful of Wi-Fi enabled thermostats. Now, just about half of the ones that we tested have that capability. So really interesting remote control possibilities.
I never thought that you could just change the thermostat and you can, I mean, what does that do? The old round thing that we're so used to is not up to date?
Yeah, that's going away. So it's really the programming.
Uh-huh.
And if you can get into the habit or the routine of lowering your temperature by about 10 degrees when you're out of the house or when you're asleep, you're going to shave anywhere from 10 to 20% off your annual energy bills, which is, you know, it quickly adds up. Yeah.
Now, did these do it automatically for you? I don't have to always go and like do that little turning thing when I leave the house?
Exactly, yeah. So this one, you set it once, and then, you know, then forget about it. It goes over. If we move up over to the Honeywell Lyric, this has this is sort of our most innovative. It uses what's known as geofencing technology. So it basically knows where you are or knows where your smartphone is more accurately and adjusts the temperature in your house accordingly. So when you're a mile away from home, for example, it will turn the heat on so that when you get home, the house is nice and toasty.
Man, I just know where I am.
That freaks some people out. It's a little sort of big brotherly, but we haven't seen any sort of, you know, any security issues or, you know, with these.
But it did answer the question I had, which is, can you program it from your smartphone? All of these?
Only these two.
Okay.
Yeah, so these two are Wi-Fi enabled. When we get down to the Lux, this is our value. It's our CR Best Buy, $70. But you can see it's the trade-off is not it's a much more basic design. So it doesn't have sort of the bells and whistles.
Yeah, but that's
the
good.
It is good
because
yeah,
not everybody needs. It can be intimidating with too many bells and whistles. You just need to tell me on, off, when, how much, you know, what temperature to set it at, and how long it's going to stay there.
Exactly. Yeah. If you're not a real techie, this is the way to go.
And it's nice and big. You can read it.
Very clear. Again, that's really one of the things we're looking for. Those clear prompts and easy to read graphics.
How much can you save? I mean, if you turn the temperature down 10 degrees,
right,
then you got to get it up 10 degrees when you get home. So
right,
does it really save money?
No, it does, and we really crunch the numbers, and so you can save about $150, depending on what your current costs are.
But, over the course of a year.
It's very quickly going to pay for itself, which is really the important point.
Can you have multiples of these in your home if you want to? Yes or no?
No, unless you have zones. It gets complicated if you have zones.
You gotta have a big fancy
upstairs,
house for that.
Downstairs.
Levels.
How about a fireplace?
Thank you, Dan DeClerico.
Really,
that was very interesting. Thanks so much.
Great.
And that is gonna do it for us. Stick around though. Julie Banderas is up next with the Fox.